Hi, this is Libby Frank, and I love myself some EUT. Now that bitch, you'll never get to, can't get what you want, so you're acting like a punk. You were too fly then, so fly away now. Now that bitch.
I'm Jalera, this is Libby Frank, how are you?
Yes, I'm doing good, how are you?
Not too bad.
Good.
How are you feeling right about now? Excited?
I'm very excited. I'm so excited because the single's doing so well. Mm-hmm. I'm on my radio promo tour, so everything's happening, everything's falling into place.
Getting much spare time at the moment?
Not really. No? Not really. But when I do, I just always want to get back to work anyway. Not for the taking, I'm not a bender.
Return to sender. Where are you living now then? Do you live here?
I live in Barbados now.
You live in Barbados, yeah? You ever come back to, here?
Yeah, well, I was born in Harrogate and I left when I was 5 because my father's family is from Barbados and my mom is from the UK. So when I moved to Barbados, I always used to come back every summer because my half and my family is here. So.
Okay. Where does your name come from? Tell us about that.
My name is Olivia and my friends call me Livy, so that's where the Livy came from.
Sure.
Frank is actually my late grandfather's name. Okay. And the reason why I used it is because he was the first person to notice that I was going to be a musician, because when I was 2 years old, I was at the piano and I was sort of really focused, you know, playing it, and, you know, I don't know what I was playing, probably a bunch of junk, but I was really focused on it, you know. So he looked at me and he looked at my family who were in the room and said, just watch out, she's going to be a musician. So,
called it from young.
Yeah.
So at the moment, you more touring or you're in the studio? What's happening with you?
Well, I finished recording my album. Mm-hmm. And right now we're in the selection process of picking the songs for the album.
Okay.
12 songs out of 100. Because I've written and recorded quite a lot. Yeah, so I'm on the road, I'm doing radio promo. I just finished my US promo tour, where I went all over the place, from LA to New Jersey to New York, everywhere. Mm-hmm. And I've been in England for the last 10 days doing some radio promo and performances here.
Okay.
And I went to Notting Hill Carnival for some performances there as well. It was my first time doing Notting Hill, and it was great because, you know, I haven't been back home to Barbados for a while, and, you know, the Monday of the actual, you know, Notting Hill Carnival, it was nice and warm, and mm-hmm. It felt like home, because I missed out on crop over, you know, for the last couple of years, so I'm compensated pretty well. Now let them know who you are.
How about the album? How long are we talking about for the album?
Well, as I said, we're in the selection process right now. Mm. It's finished being recorded. So I think it's going to be released at the beginning of next year. So you can look out for that.
Lovely. You're working with a lot of people on there that have worked with a lot of other people and stuff.
Yeah.
Anybody you haven't worked with that you'd like to?
I'd love to work with will.i.am. I think he's a great producer. Also, Max Martin has done a lot of stuff with Britney Spears. Mm-hmm. Also, David Guetta seems to be doing some cool stuff nowadays too.
That's very nice.
Yeah.
Who inspires you? Who do you like?
The first album that I got was actually Sade, Lovers Rock.
Love Sade.
I love her. I think
so
she's
much.
Great.
Where
I think she's
she?
Coming out soon, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
Where's she been?
I know. It's been a while.
She's awesome.
Yeah, but I think she's great. I love Gwen Stefani, Nelly Furtado, The Cranberries, mm-hmm. Alanis Morissette, Bob Marley. It's a huge range of different artists, and they've all influenced me in a great way.
Good stuff. All right, I've got some questions here from Twitter.
Okay.
Yeah, you know Twitter, right?
Yes.
Make sure you're following me after this interview.
We'll see.
The first question says, what's your favorite cartoon? Could be like what you used to watch, or maybe now.
My favorite cartoon is Scooby-Doo. Actually, right now I love Family Guy.
Family Guy.
does that sort of still is that
adult
cartoon?
We'll use Scooby.
Okay, when I was young, Scooby. Now it's Family Guy.
Okay, cool. Yeah. Scooby-Doo.
Yeah.
When was the last time you ran as fast as you could? Just ran for no reason. Like, let's run. Come on, let's go. Ah, run fast.
Gosh, I can't remember, but.
I wish I had these questions.
I've been running on a treadmill. I think I was doing a workout and I really wanted to push myself.
No, on the street, just ran. Come
just
on,
like,
let's go.
Just like let my hair free and just run with the wind.
Maybe on the beach.
Yeah, actually, yeah, with my dogs.
There you go.
The
last question from Twitter says, when was the last time I had hiccups? I haven't had hiccups this year myself.
Really? This for the whole year?
I haven't had them, no, not that I can remember.
Oh my gosh. The last time I had hiccups was... I think it was probably actually about a week ago.
Really?
But I have a great cure for it.
Go, stand on your head.
I know that there's like the one where you put the sugar on your tongue. But the one that really works is, you know, like your diaphragm. Like, breathe in and expand your diaphragm and hold it for as long as you can. And it goes away.
That's
completely,
it.
Yeah.
Just one.
Push your tummy out. Breathe in, push your tummy out, and it goes away.
Okay.
It works for me every single time.
I'm going to try that.
Yeah.
Next time, if I have it, you know.
Maybe this year, maybe next year.
Maybe next year. So you are signed. How did that come about? Were you just singing like on the bus or?
No, I actually had to work really hard for it. I recorded my demo in Barbados with some local producers, with some songs that I wrote. And then I went to Miami and did some more recording there. And from there I went to New York and I went around to about 5 or 6 different labels, just standing up in their conference room, you know, singing a cappella to the staff. And I went to Jive Records, which was always one of my top picks. And they were the ones that showed great doing in my life.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Last couple of questions. What does swagger mean to you?
Swagger means confidence and, you know, not, you know, okay, swagger is the perfect guy for me, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's about not, I don't have to baby them. I don't have to be their mother. They have ambitions and goals. Are you looking a bit guilty there?
Yeah. I like scoring goals. I like soccer.
Yeah. Not soccer.
What kind of goals are you talking about? The only goals I know. Okay,
you're not my sort of guy then.
I mean, I hate football. What's soccer? Anyway, go on.
But yeah, just being confident. I think that's the main thing. Having that swagger is like, yeah. But not like, you know, not obnoxious or anything.
Not too much. Just
balance. Yeah, not too much of an ego, but yeah.
Okay, cool. And it says here, back then you blanked me, is a lyric in your song, right?
Yeah.
Do they say that anywhere else? I thought we only say that in London, like you blanked me. Like,
really?
Yeah.
No.
Is that from Barbados? Is that
well, not really. It's just, I just came, I didn't even know that they only use it in London either. I just sort of came to my head. I was
just
like,
normal,
you
yeah?
blanked me, yeah.
Okay,
to put
right.
it frankly. I think I wanted to rhyme with frankly, so I used blank me.
I see. Thank you very much for speaking to us.
Thank
it's very
you.
Very nice to meet you.
Thanks a lot.
My name's
Jalera.
This was Livy Frank. She was lovely.
Yeah.
She was lovely.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.